All right, we'll get started. We'd like to welcome Robert MacIntyre, the champion of the 2024 RBC Canadian Open, into the interview room. Robert, congratulations on your first PGA Tour victory with your father on the bag. How special was today?
It was incredible. It's everything that I've done in my life has been with the support of my family. The game of golf was kind of passed down the generations from, I got it from my dad, and luckily he's a head man in Oban, at Glencruton, and we've got a house between where you cross the road for four holes over the road at Glencruton, and we used to go out every night in the summer, no matter the weather. We'd play four holes every night, and he taught me the game of golf. And then this week when I phoned him to come and caddy for me, to be honest, I was just coming here to play a golf tournament. There was no expectation. There was a lot going on with visas and stuff during the week, and to win it with him in the bag is just, to be honest, I still can't believe that it happened.
You've locked up spots in the next three tournaments, the Memorial Tournament presented by Workday, the US Open, and the Travelers Championship. How much does this win change the rest of the season for you?
It changes everything. This is my fifth event in a row as well. I was planning to do US Open qualifier tomorrow, 36 holes with my dad in the bag. Thankfully, that's off the cards, and you know what, it's a dream come true, and I just can't believe it's happened with him in the bag. There's been a lot going on with me for caddies, and obviously I partied with Scotty last week, and I just came here, I was happy, I was in a good mind frame, and I was just out there to play golf and hit the golf shots and add them up at the end. And wasn't until late on that I really started to look at leaderboards properly and see where I was, and we done it.
All right, we'll take some questions out here. If you have a question, we'll get a microphone to you. We'll start with Jason up front.
What did you learn about yourself this week?
You know, I knew I had a hell of a fight in me. I've been working hard, really hard, on the mental side of the game. Because once we picked apart my game of golf, we realised that the game of golf isn't the problem. I'm the problem, and I've worked really hard at that with my team. And I've said it probably for the last 4 or 5 weeks that the mental side's so important to me, and this reiterates it. It's yesterday when it wasn't going well, my dad just said, "What have you been working on? What are you doing?" Hold that putt in 10, and we just switched into gear. But it just shows that I can compete at the top level. I always knew I could, but until you do it, you really don't know.
Sorry, are you going to play next week, Memorial? Or?
Yeah, well, I've not even spoken to my mum, my family, my team, my managers. I'm guessing I'm going to have to. I'd love to go home for a party, but I think we'll probably play next week.
John?
Congrats, Robert. You just spoke about the importance of sort of getting your mind right and improving, and how that improved your performance. How helpful was it having your dad on the bag from a mental perspective and a focus perspective?
To be honest, it wasn't really the focus. It was more the... said it yesterday, he's wanting me to do well just because I'm blood. There's no, he's going to get a nice paycheck out of it, and my mum and dad will be mortgage free now, and life's looking a little bit better on that side of things. But he just wants me to do well because I'm his son, and there's no angles to it. There's nothing. It's just sheer fight for me, and I fight for him as well. And coming down the last there, when I hit that 7-iron and I watched it in the sky, and I knew it was never enough club, so I hit it as hard as I could, and it was perfect. As soon as I hit it, I looked up, it was perfect, and actually a little tear in my eye, because I knew that one's going to be close, and I still had a job to do, but I just felt like the guy that's properly taught me the game of golf, I'm going to win a tournament with him in my bag, and it's so special.
So it sounds like he's going to get the caddy's percentage then?
Yeah, he'll do all right. I think I got to get rid of some money just now for tax reasons. But he'll do nicely out of it. He deserves it. Look, he was a caddy for the week, but at the end of the day, he's my dad, and it was just the emotion that you seen at the end was just almost out of sheer disbelief that we'd done it with him in the bag. I mean, the amount of work that the caddies do week in, week out, which is unbelievable help, and then I just do it with my dad that's got a yardage book. I mean, he lost a yardage book once. He couldn't get in on Monday, didn't have credentials. It was, I wouldn't have thought it.
We go to Lucas in the back right.
Congratulations, Robert, on the win. On the 18th green, there were fans with Scotland flags. One of them was yelling, "No Scotland, no party." I'm just curious how you felt the atmosphere was on the 18th and just what it meant to you this week just to have those Scottish fans out there supporting you.
No, I thought the crowds were unbelievable. All the Canadian fans were so respectful. I thought being left-handed helped on that side of it. I thought a lot of people kind of seen a bit of me in themselves as being left-handed. But I never realised how many Scots were actually in Canada. And like the support I've had in Europe, in Scotland, in Oban, has been incredible. And I just try and do my best week in, week out here. And whether it's here or on the DP World Tour, I try my best and I fight as much as I can. And today we put in a hell of a fight.
Go to Adam on the left aisle.
Hey, congratulations, obviously. I'm just curious about the Ryder Cup and the experience that you had from that. You know, obviously, Justin Rose was all over social media, was congratulating you. But, you know, now that you were in the mix for a chance to win a PGA Tour event, did you pull anything from that? And maybe what did that experience mean to you to get to this point?
No, 100%. There was a lot. The Ryder Cup helped me massively, and that man, Justin Rose, helped me a lot. I played with him Sunday at the PGA just recently. And he was making a run, and I watched the way he done things. We didn't speak a lot when we were out there because we both had a job to do, and he was going along nicely. I wasn't doing great, but I watch and I learn. When someone's doing something better than me, I watch and learn and take things from it. And he also gave me a few pointers when we're playing Ryder Cup. I mean, yeah, the guy is one of the best British golfers ever. I got to play Ryder Cup with him, but the whole experience of the Ryder Cup and being part of a winning team, and I think it would help massively. And also being a kind of team sport guy, it also pushed that a little bit more.
We'll go to Kevin and then John.
Congratulations. I was wondering where you were when you made the call to your dad and what you said, like when you asked him to caddy.
I don't know. I think I was in a house in Dallas. Look, me and Scotty done all right. We played, top 10 at Zurich with Dietrich. We had a chance to win at Myrtle Beach. But it just wasn't, I just didn't feel the connection as much as I would have wanted. But he done a great job, and I just phoned my dad, and I was like, are you able to caddy? Or, to be honest, I try to get other people, but they didn't want to do a one-weeker. And I've got a lot of decisions to make about going forward. My dad's not going to do that full-time. He's going to go home and get back on the moors and work at Glencruton. But, yeah, just, if in doubt, phone dad.
And I know your parents have been foster parents for a long time. What's that experience in having foster brothers and sisters, how has that kind of shaped your perspective in life?
I think it makes you realize that hitting the white ball around the golf course isn't the most important thing. I mean, I've been in tears over it. Kids going away from you, they become family. They've been in a tough spot. I wasn't given everything as a kid. I was given a great opportunity. My dad was obviously a really good sportsman, football, golf, shinty. Didn't have the finances to really chase it. And I think it was something that my mum and dad always wanted to do. I've got two older sisters who were right into the horses, horse riding and stuff, but they even sacrificed quite a lot of that just to give me a chance. I mean, I couldn't play in golf tournaments as a junior because we couldn't afford it. And I think that made me, that makes me fight and never give up. And I think not being given anything, I mean, they gave me quite a bit to give me the opportunity, but never was I spoon-fed it. I was always fighting for every bit of it.
John, on the right.
Congratulations. You've mentioned being a bit homesick for Scotland, and you made a trip back, a three-week trip back. How important was that? What did you sort of learn from that? And do you think that, you know, your good finish at the PGA and this week would have been possible without it?
No chance. I think, look, I went home. I was struggling. My girlfriend wasn't, we just weren't enjoying the American Orlando lifestyle that we'd thought would better my golf. And to be honest, okay, the facilities are great and at Isleworth, and I think it has helped my golf in a lot of ways with the way I have to chip it, whatnot. But when I went home, I had 3 weeks at home, touched the clubs twice in 3 weeks, pitch up at Zurich with a shoulder injury that I thought, I ain't playing golf this week from playing shinty. And took a couple of painkillers and we rock on and didn't tell Thomas anything. I just said, I got a wee sore shoulder here, but we'll be all right. And it just clears my mind being back home, and I get to spend time with the boys, a couple of beers with them, and they just treat me like Bob. And playing shinty with Oban Celtic back home, I don't get treated as Robert MacIntyre, the golfer. I get treated as Bob MacIntyre, one of the boys.
One follow-up, Rory McIlroy, he said he could relate to how different it is, the culture shock, and that he was, he said it would be great to see you get this win this week. Can you talk about a bit your relationship with him from the Ryder Cup and what he's meant for your career?
Yeah, look, Rory's a role model. He's a guy I've looked up to for many years. I actually sat with him and Shane at Zurich, and Rory asked me, how are you enjoying, or how are you finding the States? You obviously seen some of the articles, and I was like, Rory, to be honest, I've struggled. And obviously he's an only child, so he was able to have family out a lot more. And we sat and discussed it, and obviously from Ryder Cup, we gelled well. Me and Shane are probably more of a similar human beings. But no, Rory's someone that I look up to, I can ask certain questions to, and yeah, he's just a role model.
Got one over here on the left.
Robert, how big a threshold is this for you to get over, sitting up there right now with that trophy right in front of you?
It's massive. Look, I bogeyed them two holes. I hit a terrible 4-iron off the tee. Decent 6-iron, it just ran off, make bogey. But it shows my attitude to the game of golf. It shows when the going gets tough, the tough get going. And I really believe that. It's about just staying in the fight. And it didn't matter if I had lost the lead, because I still had holes to play. I could still get it back. And I was just hitting golf shots until they ran out. And that was in my head. And just miss it in the right spots and be smart about your play and just trust your hands. And that's all I've done.
Just follow up to that. Rory's talked a lot in the past with us about, you know, winning two national opens here, other national opens around the world. Is this for you, this is kind of the same thing as winning a national open, you know, especially in view of what you've done in Scotland a couple of times? Is this big?
Yeah, I think national opens are huge for professional golf or any kind of golf. I mean, look at the crowd. If it's not a national open, the crowd's maybe not as big, but Canadian Open, a lot of good Canadian golfers on the PGA Tour, and they're out there supporting them as much as they can. And I mean, when I was in Scotland, obviously Rory beat me to the post, but the support is different when it's... I feel like national opens are elevated because it is national, and there's less... It's one golf tournament, one nation, and that's what it is. And I think it's... I think it just raises the profile of the event, and the crowds come out and support it. And I mean, out there this week was incredible.
We'll go to Adam and then John.
You mentioned the mental side of the game. Are you working with a mental coach?
Yeah, I am, but that's, it wants to just stay.
You did seem to get agitated out there, especially with the drones. How did you, what was the problem with that, and how did you overcome it?
If it didn't go away, I was going to start throwing my clubs at it. That's how annoyed I was getting. I was standing on the drive of par four, and when everyone's silent, all you can hear is it's like a big wasp. Asked them to get rid of it. They did. Next hole, I'm in the bunker, and sure enough, everyone's silent, and all I hear is this buzzing again. I look up, and there it is. And I don't know, there was one of the guys must have been getting sick of me. Just I kept turning him because I knew he was a man to go to if when that drone starts annoying me. Because it was yesterday on 18, it was the same guy. And he just radioed, get this drone out of here. And then I stood on the ninth fairway, wedge shot in, and sure enough, all I can hear is this drone again. And I had enough at that point, and rules official from the RNA was just beside us, and I brought her over and I said, look, this drone needs to get out of here. I've said it three times now, the drone is annoying me, the drone's putting me off, it's too close. I mean, it's easier when the blimp's up there, but it's obviously the weather and stuff, and it's just, I had a job to do, and anything that was getting in my way was getting told to get out of the way. And that's just the way I was focused today, and that drone was doing my head in, so I told it to get away.
What was the most helpful thing your father did for you today?
Today? I think he'd done a great job this week. He just kept telling me we just stay in the fight, and he actually said to me with four or five holes to go, he goes, if we play this in one under par, they got to come get you. And he knows what to say, when to say it. And I mean, he thought that being here was a bit easier on his own mental health with watching the scores on the app. But I don't think this week's done him great with the head because of the stress. But he's a guy that's taught me the game of golf, and he knows my game inside out, and I can't thank him enough for this week.
And the last one for me. Do you have any clues going to be on the bag at the US Open or next week?
Yeah, I do. I do, but I think...
Another one you're not going to tell me?
I can't right now. But I think it's a done deal now. Well, now it is.
John, we got time for a couple more. Go to John.
Robert, there was a brief moment early in your round where Mackenzie Hughes had caught you. He was shared the lead with you. That was just after your first hole, and he was four in. Were you aware of how close he was, or aware of the field in general?
Not really. I mean, I always look at the leaderboard and see where we're at, but if it's not on the right sheet, I just don't worry about it. And look, I bogeyed it first. I bogeyed it a few times this week. And when you've got that much a lead, it's just things you got to do. And I knew the par five was going to be massive to kind of flip the momentum back for me, and it didn't really matter if I went behind, because I went behind yesterday by four shots and I managed to flip eight shots in I think ten holes, so there was no problem about that. But the problem is that can also happen to you, so you got to stay focused, and I think I done a good job of that. And just couple of the crowd started getting a bit rowdy, and I'm sure one got thrown out with some of the things he was saying, but look, it was just, I was focused on doing a job, and I done that.
We'll finish up with Jason right here.
Just when you did call your dad to come and caddy, were you aware of all the hoops you were going to have to go through as far as getting him a work visa? I think you had to go up to Ottawa to get something, or did you even think about that when you gave him the call?
Yeah, so I mean there's so much that goes through it. I was going up there to get a visa to get back in the US. I had trouble getting in the US for Zurich because I hadn't the P1 visa in my passport. I was told I could still travel on the ESTA. I realized I couldn't when I was sitting in secondary at Dublin Airport, thinking I'm not going to Zurich. And so this week, obviously, I turned up Monday morning. We couldn't get my dad through the door because he didn't have any credentials. So it was a bit of hassle trying to sort that out. And I then flew to Ottawa Monday night after getting soaked on nine holes with my dad. Got my visa, thankfully, picked up 3 o'clock Tuesday, flew back here. Got in here about 11 o'clock on Tuesday night, and luckily we requested to play the Pro-Am on Wednesday, and they done that. They granted me nine holes, and we didn't really have an expectation, and it was just, everything was just carnage until we actually stepped on the golf course on Thursday.
And just excuse my ignorance, but Shinty, can we make some comparisons to hockey? Can you give us a little bit of...
I think if it's like, so it's the physicality of ice hockey. It's obviously it's not in a rink, but it's, I mean, I went to my first game there in Dallas, and it's rough and tough. It's a lot of body contact, and I would say it's more like field hockey with no rules. I think a lot of you will have seen hurling from Shane Lowry. So it's like a cross between hurling and field hockey. Rough and tough, and it's what I've been brought up doing. My dad was a really good player, and I mean, I stupidly still play, but it's part of me.
All right, Robert, congratulations again, and thank you for your time.
Thank you.